You're more likely to want a default value for type properties, also called class properties. You can think of class properties as belonging more to the class itself than to any one instance of a class, because they don't vary across objects. A type property has the same value for every instance of a class. We use type properties mostly for data we want every instance of a class to have easy access to. For example, if we had a class called KidsMovie, we might want a type property called PermittedRatings to keep track of which ratings are permissible for children. To indicate that PermittedRatings is a type property, we place the word static or class in front of its definition. Type properties are also referred to as static properties in languages like C and Java. The value of this property won't change across movies, but it's nice to have these ratings at our fingertips. It'd also be nice if we had some information about the reviews for these movies. Let's add an array of reviews from different media outlets. But then, of course, it'd be really convenient if we could see the average of the reviewer scores. Let's call it a metascore, like the app Metacritic. Such a metascore is known as a computed property, a property that's computed based on existing data in the class. Computed properties have custom getters and optionally custom setters. This one doesn't really need a setter, though. Here's our custom getter. You probably haven't seen this reduce function before. It's a handy method for reducing the values of an array to one value. For a fun challenge, see if you can figure out exactly what this code is doing and post what you find on the discussion forum. For now, I'll just tell you that it's returning the average of all the scores in this array. Let's test out our getter. We'll initialize a movie with some reviewer scores and then access the metascore using dot syntax. Sweet! This one ought to be a crowd pleaser. Now, in looking at the custom getter for our metascore, it may have occurred to you, wait a second, what about the getters and setters for the other properties? Guess what? We don't have to write them! They're automatically created when you declare a property.